Hey everybody, happy Halloween. I'm going back to Steve's and hopefully he's got something scary for me, something good and juicy, and I'll see you up there.
Hello, John.
Cat or queen at the movies.
Johnny, I got the perfect Halloween date combination for you. It's called Hangover Square and The Lodger. These are two movies that were made 1944 and 1945, a 20th Century Fox. They were directed by this guy named John Brom. He was 20th Century Fox's version of Val Lewton, because Zanuck had seen that Val Lewton was doing Cat People and Curse of the Cat People for like little money at the other studio, and they were making a lot of money. So he brought this English director over, and they were very atmospheric. They starred this extremely huge homosexual named Laird Krieger. Laird Krieger was very, very eloquent, very, very articulate. He had been stuck, though, playing like giant guys, you know, and he was very soft-spoken in his way. Then they cast him as Jack the Ripper in The Lodger, and he brings this sort of whole gay feeling to it. He's very, very sensitive, you know, very, very quiet, and he's got these eyes that just, like, come through you. And you can tell he's kind of in love with his brother. And they do a really neat thing with, he keeps showing his brother's portrait, you know, I love this brother, look at his mouth, look at his eyes, look at his mouth, look at his eyes, you know, and the landlady's kind of, the landlady's played by Sarah Allgood, who was the mother in How Green Was My Valley, of all those sons, you know, a little bit, and all the sons were like this. It's a birth problem. We're not even going to go into that. But the thing that happened is they put Merle Oberon as this singer, and the lodger comes and stays in her apartment while the murders are happening in Whitechapel. He films a murder with this woman, wonderful character actress named Doris Lloyd, and instead of like showing the killer doing it, it's all a reaction shot, and she's sitting on the bed, and she knows he's behind her, and she turns around, and there's nowhere for her to run, and she can't scream, and she's... It's one of the most terrifying murders I think ever done. It was such a big hit, The Lodger was such a big hit, that they decided to repeat it. So the next year they put George Sanders as the inspector again, and they John Brom again directing, and they did this play called Hangover Square, which was a novel by the guy that wrote Gaslight, Patrick Hamilton. Then this one, Laird Krieger plays a composer, and he's a pianist, and every time he hears a discordant chord, it makes him insane and he kills people. And he's in love with Linda Darnell. Oh, God, Linda Darnell, the great dark beauty, aside from Jean Tierney, of 20th Century Fox, who later burned to death when she was like 41, watching her very first movie, Stardust, on television. She fell asleep with a lighted cigarette. Anyway, her great fear was being burned alive. She had a horrible fear of it, kind of like Natalie Wood did with water, had a fear of water. And Linda Darnell, like in three movies, in Anne and the King of Siam, she was burned at the stake. In this movie, she gets strangled and thrown out of Guy Fawkes' fire and burned up. And in Forever Amber, she almost burned up during the big fire sequence when the set caught on fire and they couldn't get her out fast enough. I mean, the poor girl, and then she died in a fire anyway. So Laird Krieger was meanwhile doing this huge weight reduction thing because he wanted to be considered a leading man. He was too fey. He had lost Waldo Leidecker to Clifton Webb in Laura, and he knew that right away people thought of him as a heavy. You know, it's kind of a metaphor. Heavy, heavy, heavy. And he was heavy. But so anyway, he was doing this massive weight reduction, and as soon as this movie finished, he died of a massive heart attack at like 31 years old. The poor guy. And this was a crowning achievement. This one has a score by Bernard Herrmann, who had just come to Hollywood with Citizen Kane with Orson Welles and done that score. And Alfred Newman saw Bernard Herrmann and said, I want him at Fox. I can't write all these scores. And he gave him Jane Eyre and then Hangover Square. And he wrote this brooding, brooding piano concerto. And at the end of Hangover Square, he's sitting at this, playing this, and the whole house is on fire around him, and he's burning alive, and he's playing his concerto for the last time as the flames reach up. It's the perfect Hollywood thing. Take it from Tired Old Queen at the Movies. The Lodger and Hangover Square, these you need to see.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat.